Senator Sabi, before the break, there was a question about the invitation you sent out to Inspector General of Police, where you mentioned the case of one of your colleagues, Senator Dino Melaye, and the perception that the only time you seem to get very heated is when your own members are affected, as opposed to issues pertaining to Nigerians. How do you respond to that?
Well, you know, in situations like this, everybody is entitled to his opinion. And you must respect every views that people express. Before that particular episode, we have earlier on invited the IG and he refused to come. He took us to court. And the court ruled that within the context of Section 88 and the section empowering him to also carry out investigation, we are all legally empowered to carry out our duty. And that for that, he ought to respect the summons to appear before the Senate. Now, this particular episode, a lot of things were happening, issues around insecurity. And of course, let me say, from my understanding, that the issue of Senator Dino was like a trigger that says, look, there are a number of issues now. Let's invite the IG to know what is happening. And for me, if you invite the IG to come and appear before us, like the argument went that time, if he felt this issue was already in court, and of course, because of that...
Because he did appear at some point, yes, but with a lawyer,
but yes.
And so he refused to answer questions on the basis that
is it. And that
the
was
issue
why he took
was
us
in
to
court.
Yes. So within that context, if he had appeared, first he will have achieved two things. He will be able to at least show that he respects the institution of the Senate as an institution. And, of course, the simple question or the simple response will be, well, this matter is in court. I'm sorry, I cannot give you any further information.
Okay.
But then, to answer the question she raised, the subject of invitation included the issues of insecurity.
Okay. Let me have very little time, so that's why I'm interrupting you. Mr. Clement Nwankwo, I want to quickly ask you, in situations where the judiciary has been invited, we have sort of found some sort of resolution. For example, when the National Assembly wanted to change the order of elections. And so I'm wondering, why is there a reluctance generally to bring this third arm of government into what is happening between the National Assembly and the executive as a way of mediating these issues? Because they're supposed to be the final arbiters, aren't they?
They are, if it goes before them. Certainly there are issues here of reluctance on the part of certain officials of government to respect the legislature. The legislature, for me, is the difference between dictatorship and democracy. And I think that any arm of government that seeks to undermine the legislature threatens democracy. And I think that several...
But isn't that the case only where all these institutions are functioning optimally and are behaving themselves and are doing things ethically and morally? So that separation of power that you're talking about presupposes that every arm of government is behaving properly.
Well, you wouldn't have excellence in behavior. Certainly there are challenges with some of the aspects of the work that the legislature is doing.
Okay.
With the executive, of course, there are challenges as well. What we are making, the point we're making is that we need to defend this democracy, and the way the legislature is being treated doesn't help.
Okay, and I have to give the final words to the Attorney General very quickly because we've got to go.
Yes. Well, the truth of the matter about it all is that we must, within the context of the spirit of democracy, learn to operate within bounds as far as our respective constitutional rights and responsibilities are concerned. Where there is an attempt by any arm of the government, be it judiciary, executive or legislature, to work out of bounds, then it naturally creates chaos and problems.
Thank you so much. We have run out of time. Thank you to my panel, to my studio audience, and to all of you at home. Don't forget to join us for the next edition of The Core on Wednesday, the 4th of July, where we'll be discussing restructuring with two governors as well as representatives from both the APC, the PDP and other parties. On behalf of Channels Television and Daria Media, I'm Kadria Ahmed, wishing you a very good evening.